XRP, we start with 1 hour chart. First of all, if we refer to our analysis in my last video, since the price was within this move, I was keep highlighting the price can drop and exactly as what we expected the price drop. That's why I mentioned if we want to look for buy, the best thing is if the price drop. Because we mentioned we had the sharp move and corrective, we can expect the price to drop. That's why when the price was within this move, I mentioned it's not really good idea to look for buy, even if any bond bought here after they see this one, because the only way to look for buy having entry above the top. If anyone bought here after they see this move, they should take out the trade. Okay. Anyway, as what we expected, the price drop and now we want to see what's the next. In this case, we move to daily chart. Okay. It's still, if we refer to the daily chart, the way we're looking at this, similar to what we expected. I mean, what we discussed in my last analysis, either we put this one as a flat in relative to this, and this is the start of the down move, or we consider this is the only down move. And because in the bigger picture, we have this. And we consider this is the start of the up move. That's mean we have a flat. And mostly we are looking for this. That's mean we're expecting this one turn to a deeper move. If we get any trade set up for buy, we will take the trade. Because if we want to consider this one as a flat and this one is going to retest the previous low, in that case, what we're looking for can turn to a really deep correction. Okay, and we don't want to see the breakout of, we don't want to see the price enter this zone, which is below the 0.6. Okay, and even if this one is in relative to this, what's the next move even we get can be sharp as what we have here is very rare this one happen. Okay, that's why we are mostly, we prefer this one. If we get any reversal, we want to look for buy. In this case, we move to forward chart and right now we're looking at this one in relative to this. We're looking at this one as internal flat. That's why we have been looking for price to drop since the price was within this move. And right now this is what we get. Now, if how deep it can go, this is the zone we are looking for. Based on 1 hour chart, I will highlight. But if we get any reversal, this is what we're looking for. That means we're looking for buy. Because if we move to 1 hour chart, the price haven't retested the previous low. But from now, we can look for divergence. If we refer to the indicators, almost divergence is there. Okay, that means if the price break or tag, mostly we have a divergence. Okay, now the only question is, since we have a shadow, do we need to wait for the breakout of the previous low to consider as a divergence, or we can consider this part? I mean, we video the shadow. All right, which one we should consider, because each of them can give us a different definition. But what I can see from now, since the Bitcoin almost broke the previous low in the Bitcoin structure and they are following each other, if we get any reversal from now, we can look for buy. But the best thing is this one conform with the breakout of the previous low. All right, how deep it can go if there is a continuation, we can expect the price drop to 0.8888 following by 84. That means if the price drop to any, at least to 88 cent, any reversal for long term, it can give us a very good trade setup. Okay. I need to highlight here. It doesn't mean the price cannot break and continue, because we mentioned based on daily chart, based on bigger picture, because we mentioned we have two different options. But to look for buy, as long as the price break the previous low, if I see the reversal, if I see the trade setup for buy, this is what I'm looking for. That's me from now. After the breakout of the previous low, if I see any reversal, I will take the trade and I will start to manage. Okay, whether the price can reverse from here or continue, all it depends what we get here. If we get a correction here, mostly we can look for continuation. But whether we should look for sell or not, we are not really interested to look for sell. We are more interested to look for buy. But right now, we cannot confirm with the reversal because we don't see any reversal point. The best thing is this one drops some more, a confirmation with the breakout of the previous low. Then from there, we can look for buy. In this case, we just follow the chart. If I see any update or any reversal, I will share. Thanks.